हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? यस माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, आई होप एवरीवन इज़ फाइन एट होम एंड एवरीथिंग इज़ गोइंग वेल टू. ओके, यस माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, सो टिल प्रीवियस पीरियड ऑफ इंग्लिश, नाउ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑल द पोर्शन फॉर द पीटी टेस्ट वन, पीरियोडिक टेस्ट वन, राइट? जस्ट लाइक ग्रामर 7 चैप्टर्स वी हैव फिनिश्ड, देन रीडर 3 लेसन्स वी हैव फिनिश्ड, एंड नाउ वायली ऑल्सो वी हैव फिनिश्ड टिल स्पीकिंग पार्ट 2. एम आई राइट? यस माय डियर जी. सो फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स वंस अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू रिवाइज द चैप्टर्स ऑफ द ग्रामर. ओके, सो वॉट वॉज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ द ग्रामर चिल्ड्रन? इट इज पजेसिव्स. ओके चिल्ड्रन, वॉट इज मीन बाय पजेसिव्स? हु विल टेल मी? जस्ट थिंक. पजेसिव्स मीन्स अ पर्टिक्युलर थिंग बिलोंग्स टू हूम, दैट इज नोन एज पजेसिव. ओके, यस, सो नाउ विल सी डीप अबाउट द पजेसिव्स. एवरी वन, नाउ यू विल ओपन योर ग्रामर टेक्स्ट बुक. Yes, and it is the first lesson. And the page number is 1 number only. First number is the yes. Children, see here. Before starting the lesson, there is warm-up activity given. So we'll read this. Does this bag belong to you? No, this is that girl's bag. Whose bags are these? These are those girls' bags. Now children, what we have to do is look at the highlighted nouns. Notice the use of the apostrophe. Why has it been used in different ways? Okay, see here. In this conversation, see here, girls are the highlighted words, right? See here, this one is the first and here is another. Okay, now my dear children, what is the difference between these two highlighted words? Just observe these words and try to say me where is the apostrophe sign. Now, do you know what is meant by apostrophe sign? Apostrophe sign means it is a just like a comma, but comma is always below. This apostrophe sign is always upper side. You can see here in this word also and in this. So, where is the exact place for this apostrophe? Children, in the first highlighted word, the apostrophe sign is before S, right? And in the another word, it after the S. Okay, this is the difference. Now let's see what is given. Let us learn about possessives. Okay, we are also going to learn how the possessive form of noun is different from the plural noun. Now children, below the table is given. First of all, look at these words, noun and their possessives. Two columns are given. So the first one, what is the noun? The noun is girl. What is the possessive for it? It is girls. Second is cat. What is the possessive for it? It is cats. In the another column, the noun is parul. And the apostrophe for it is, sorry, and the possessives for it is paruls. Next is child. This is the noun. And what is the possessive for it? It is childs. Okay, so these are the nouns given with their possessive forms.
Nouns have possessive form for which we add an apostrophe. Possessives show possession. Possession means a particular thing belongs to whom. Okay, that possessive shows possession. And what is meant by apostrophe? See here, it is the sign given. In the bracket you can see, no? This is known as apostrophe. What we call apostrophe. Yes. Now see here, for example, the boy's bat. Now children, here in this case, the bat belongs to whom? Whose bat it is? Boy's. So the bat belongs to the boy. Second is the boy's mother. It means the mother of the boy. Whose mother it is? That particular boy. Boy's mother. Third is the boy's teacher. It means the teacher who teaches the boy. Okay. See, in the first case, it is bat. It is a thing. So that bat belongs to that boy. Second is the boy's mother. It means the mother of the boy. And the boy's teacher. It means the teacher who teaches the boy. Okay. Now, look at how possessives are formed. See here, we'll see. In the first case, we add apostrophe s to singular noun. Understood? Suppose in the sentence there is a singular noun, then we add only apostrophe s to the singular noun. For example, boy's teacher. Now children, here in this case, boy is a singular noun. Okay, so we can call it as a boy's teacher. So only after boy we have to write apostrophe sign and then we'll write s after it. Second is we add an apostrophe to plural nouns that end in s. Now children, in some sentences there are plural nouns given. And you know that we know most of the plural nouns are ending with s. So children, the plural nouns which are ending with s, in such a case, only we have to write the apostrophe sign. Need not write to s after apostrophe. Understood, children? When the noun is in the singular form, then we will write apostrophe also and after that s also. But when the noun is in the plural form, need not write to. And especially in the case, the plural forms, the plural words which ends with s. In this case, need not write to apostrophe s. Only we have to write the apostrophe sign after it. Are you getting my point? See here in the example. See, girl's teacher. It means children, there are many girls. Not only one girl, there are many girls, means more than one girl. Understood? So that teacher, who is teaching to all the girls. So girl's teacher means already there are girls. It means plural noun and which is ends with s. So only we have to write apostrophe after s. See here it is mentioned. Girl's teacher. And children, in the third case, we add apostrophe s to plural nouns that do not end in s. Okay, it means the plural nouns are there, but those nouns which are not ending by s. Tell me the plural nouns which are not ending by s. For example, child. What is the plural form of the child? It is not childs. Right? Child, children. Hena? So the children is a plural form which do not end with s. Am I right? So in this case, we have to add apostrophe s after the word. See here. We add apostrophe s to plural nouns that do not end in s. For example, children's teacher. Children, actually already there are children's, means more than one child. There are many children. So the teacher who teaches to all the children. Right? So in this case, we have to write apostrophe s. Understood till here, everyone? See children, there are three rules. The first one, we add apostrophe s to the singular nouns. Okay, boy, girl, tree, mother, father, hai na? Watchman. These are the singular nouns. So we have to add apostrophe sign also and s also. This is our first rule. What is the second rule for it? Children, the second rule is we add an apostrophe to plural nouns that ends in s. That end in s. It means, children, there are some plural nouns which ends with s. For example, girl is a singular noun. What is the plural form of the girl? It is girls. Already we have wrote s after girl to make it plural. Right? So the possessive form for it is only we have to add apostrophe after the s. Children, this rule is only applicable for the words, for the plural words which are ending by s. Understood? And the third one rule is the words, they are the plural form. They are the plural words, but they are not ending with s. They do not end in s. In these words, we have to add apostrophe s. For example, children, child, children. Hai na? So children, this is the word which do not end with s. So in this case, we have to add apostrophe s. Yes, my dear children. Till here, everyone understood? If you have any doubt, any queries, you can ask me by mail. So I am there to clarify your doubts. My mail ID is ivbct@pratibhaintschool.org. Yes. So shall we continue? Here, children, question A is there. What we have to do is we have to write the possessive form correctly. The children have gone to their grandparents' house. This is the sentence. Now, children, in this sentences, we have to write the possessive form correctly. Now, just first one example I will explain. Now, just in the first sentence, the children have gone to their grandparents' house. This is the sentence. Now, children, in this sentence, for which word we have to write possessive form? First, that we have to identify, no? The children have gone to their grandparents' house. Where are the children they are going? They have gone to their grandparents' house. Grandparents' house. Whose house it is? Grandparents. So we have to write apostrophe s in this word. Now, children, where we will write it? Already it is plural, grandparents, and the plural word which ends with s. So in such case, what we have to do? Just check the answer here. It is. So the first one. The children have gone to their grandparents' house. In such case, we have to add apostrophe, only the sign of apostrophe after the s. Understood? See here. It means only no, children, I am unable to write by this E tool. So here are the answers. You can use that and you can write the answer. The children have gone to their grandparents' house. Second one, Raju is riding his brother's bicycle. Raju is riding his brother's bicycle. This is the sentence. Now children, here in this sentence, his brother is a singular form. Am I right? Brother is a singular form. So whenever there is a singular word is there, we have to add apostrophe sign also and s also after that word. So Raju is riding his brother's bicycle. So here the apostrophe sign will come before s. See here. It will come before s. Why before s? Because brother is a singular noun. So brother's bicycle. It will come before s. Understood till here everyone? Yes. We'll continue with the third one. The geese's cries could be heard. The geese's cries could be heard. This is the sentence. Now children, whose cries it is? Geese's. So where we have to add apostrophe s? Already children, it is the plural form of the goose. And the word is ending with s. So simple thing is only we have to add apostrophe sign after the word. No children, it is not like that. The geese's cries could be heard. Goose, geese. Geese is the plural form. So it means it is not ending by s. It ends with e. So we have to add apostrophe s in it. You can see here. Goose is the singular form and geese is the plural form. So G-E-E-S-E, geese. The word is ending with E. It means we have to add apostrophe sign also and S also. Understood? Fourth one, men's wallets are displayed in that section. Men's wallet are displayed in that section. Children, whose wallets? Men's wallet. Now see here, men is a word, already it is a plural form. Man is the singular form and men is the plural form. Man, men. Children, this word do not end with s. Am I right? Though it is a plural form, but it do not end with s. So only we have to add apostrophe sign before s. See here. This is the answer, fourth one. Na? Man, main, plural form. But this main word is not ending with s. So for that, we have to use apostrophe s. Understood? Yes, children. So like this, you have to solve this question number A. I think everyone understood what we have to do here is, see here in the box what is given. The possessive form usually occurs before another noun. For example, the boy's car, the teacher's student, girl's school. It means when we use the possessive form, usually occurs before the another noun. See here also children in the first one sentence. The children have gone to their grandparents' house. So grandparents is, here is the apostrophe s, and house is the another noun in the sentence. So before that we have to use, we used apostrophe s or possessive form. Understood? So I told you till fourth number sentences in the question A. Children, you will complete it up to sentences 10. Means the whole A question you will solve. And here are the answers. Okay? So according to this, you will write down and complete the question number A. If you want, you can pause the video, write down the answers. Shall we continue? Here also, children, replace the underlined words with the correct possessive form only where required. Now here what we have to do is, here is the question number B and here are 10 sentences given. In that 10 sentences, some part of the sentence is underlined. So we have to replace the underlined word with the correct possessive form, but only where required. We have to change, we have to replace. For example, the wife of the doctor is a chemist. This is the first one sentence. Okay. The wife of the doctor is a chemist. Now the underlined part is the wife of the doctor. So children, instead of writing this big sentence, the wife of the doctor, instead of writing this whole part, we can write it possessive form like this, the doctor's wife. Have you understood? The wife of the doctor. It means whose wife it is? Doctor's wife. So we can write instead of this whole sentence, the doctor's wife is a chemist. See here. Only we have to replace the underlined part. Rest of the all the sentence you have to write like that only. So what is the underlined part? The wife of the doctor. So instead of that part, we can write the doctor's wife. Have you understood, children? Yes, very good. Second number is, the parents of Saurav have gone on a holiday to Australia. What is the second number sentence? The parents of Saurav have gone on a holiday to Australia. Now the underlined part is the parents of Saurav. What is the underlined part? The parents of Saurav. So instead of writing this much, only we will write the Saurav's parent. Are you clear? Are you getting my point? The parents of Saurav, instead of this, we will write the Saurav's parents like this. See here. Second. Saurav's parents. Understood? Am I right? Yes, children. So like this, we have to solve this question number B. Okay? Let's see here in the box what is given. We add apostrophe S or only apostrophe sign to a noun when it is the name of a person, an animal or a country. We do not use apostrophe S with the name of a thing. Yes, children, while writing the exercise B, you will note down this rule. When we are writing the name of a thing, that time we can't use apostrophe S. Only we can use the apostrophe S or apostrophe sign whenever it is the name of a person, animal or a country. Have you understood? Suppose there is a name of a thing, then we do not use apostrophe S. Understood? Yes. So children, this question number B also you will write. 10 sentences are given here. So you will write and the answers of these 10 sentences are here. You can observe, you can read it carefully and you can write down the answers. Okay. Again, here are some rules given. Fourth number is, with proper nouns ending in S, the possessive form takes apostrophe S. For example, Vikas house, James car. Children, these are the proper noun. Now, do you know what is meant by proper noun? Hai na? Proper noun means it is the name of a particular person. Am I right? So here Vikas and James, these two are the proper nouns which are already ends with S. Are you getting? These two proper nouns, they are already ends with S. So though these nouns are ending with S, so after that S we have to add apostrophe S to make it possessive. Vikas house. Whose house it is? Vikas house. Vikas is a proper noun, already ends with S. But after that we have to add apostrophe S to it. Same like that, James car. James is a proper noun which already ends with S. Okay. So we have to add apostrophe S after James. Have you understood this rule? Very good. Number 5. However, when writing the possessive of some proper nouns which end in S, we do not add another S after the apostrophe. See children, English is a language, so there are some exceptional cases also. So when we are writing the possessive of some proper noun which ends in S, in that case, we do not add another S after apostrophe. For example, Socrates' students, Jesus' disciples. So here are the proper nouns, Socrates and Jesus. These two nouns are already ending with S. Now, though they are the proper noun, but we can't use apostrophe S after these noun. Only we have to write apostrophe sign. We do not add another S after this proper noun. Getting? Number 4 number rule is there. Vikas and James, these two are the proper nouns, but still after these two nouns apostrophe S is used. Na? But here in the case Socrates and Jesus, after this, though these words are the proper noun and ending with S, but only we have to add apostrophe sign. We don't add another S after these words. Are you getting my point, children? Have you cleared? Yes, very good. These are the answers of the question B. If you want, you can pause the video and write down the answers. Now, plural nouns and possessive nouns. See here, notice how plural nouns are different from possessive nouns. Plurals expresses more than one of the noun. Possessives express who owns or possesses what. This is the main difference, children. Plural nouns means more than one noun. But possessives means it expresses the particular thing belongs to whom or who owns or possesses what. See here, noun, singular, plural is given. Regular noun what, children? The regular noun is girl. Okay, which is singular in form and regular day-to-day life we are using. Girl. So what is the plural of the girl? G-I-R-L, girl. And the plural form for it is girls, G-I-R-L-S. One girl, many girls. Now children, in case of possessive noun, suppose the in the sentence singular noun girl is there, G-I-R-L, girl. So for that singular noun we have to make a possessive noun. What we will write? Girl is a singular noun, so we will write apostrophe sign also, and after that S. Girl, girls. And in case of plural form, girls, G-I-R-L-S, girls. Already this is the plural form and this plural word ends with S. So in such case, what I said just now, what I told, only we can write apostrophe sign. We can't add another S. Are you getting my point? See here in the chart, you can observe that girl is a singular, possessive for it is girls. And girls, already it is the plural form. So possessive for it is only we have to add apostrophe sign, not another S for it. Understood children till here? Everyone? Yes, very good. Now here, circle the possessive nouns and underline the regular nouns. 10 sentences are given. What we have to do is, in this sentence, where are the possessive nouns that we have to circle? And where are the regular nouns that we have to underline? Okay? The read first one. These are our neighbor's chairs. In this sentence, there is the possessive noun, children. Now, very simple thing it is, how to identify the possessive nouns? How to identify? By apostrophe S. So, in this sentence, where is the apostrophe S? In the word neighbors. So, possessive noun is neighbor. So, what we have to do is, we have to circle it. First, we will circle neighbors. And another noun, we have to, regular noun, we have to underline. So, what is the regular noun here? It is chairs. So, we will underline it. Have you understood? See, here are the answers given. Possessive noun is neighbors. Regular noun for is neighbors. That second one is in the second sentences. These tables belong to our neighbors. In this sentence, children, there is no possessive noun. Only regular noun. So here you can underline. Because in the second sentence, there is no possessive noun. Third one, Deepika's room is untidy. Here, apostrophe S is there. It means third number sentence is having possessive noun. So, we'll circle to Deepika's. Have you understood, children, how we have to solve this question C? Yes, read the sentences carefully. In which sentence the possessive nouns are there, it means apostrophe S is there, that word you will circle and regular nouns you will underline. Okay, so in this way you will complete this question number C. These are the answers for the question number C. You can pause the video and write down the answers. Yes, children. Now here, question number D is the homework for you. In the next period, we'll cross-check the answers for it. In question number D also, I think there are total 10 questions. Yes, see. Here, 1 to 6 are given and here, 7 to 10 sentences are given. So, what you have to do is only choose the correct form of the noun given in the bracket and fill in the blanks. So, you will read that, write down the proper answers, and in the next period, we will cross-check these answers. I hope you have understood what we saw in this period. If you have any doubt, any queries, please feel free to ask me by mail. My mail ID is ivbct@pratibaintschool.org. Okay, everyone understood? Yes, children. So, here is the short recap of the whole lesson, of the whole period, what we saw. See here. This is Natasha's skirt. This is Tom's hat. This is Dan's photograph. This is Nikki's cat. Here, children, a noun can show what it owns or possesses. Now, in these sentences, children, the skirt, hat, photograph, cat, these all the things which belongs to the particular persons. So, for that, apostrophe S is used. So, the noun can show what it owns or possesses. Here, see. This is Natasha's skirt. This is Tom's hat. This is Dan's photograph. This is Nikki's cat. We add an apostrophe S to a noun to show ownership. Now, children, here in all these sentences, we added apostrophe S to the particular noun only. Not the other words. It means, for example, this is Natasha's skirt. So, in this sentence only we add apostrophe S to that particular word Natasha. Why? To show the ownership. It means that skirt belongs to whom? The skirt belongs to Natasha. Understood? So, that is why we have add an apostrophe S to a noun to show the ownership. Next is, a noun that shows ownership or relationship is a possessive noun. In the third number, see here, children, in the third number, the words which are containing apostrophe S, that words are indicated in the red color. Why? Because they shows the ownership or relationship. Natasha's skirt. Here is the ownership. Whose skirt it is? Natasha's. Tom's hat. Ownership. Whose hat it is? Tom's hat. So they are known as possessive noun. It means a noun that shows ownership or relationship is a possessive noun. A possessive noun always comes before the noun that belongs to it. Now here in the sentence, the cat's dishes. Now where is the possessive noun? The possessive noun is cats, and it comes before the noun that belongs to it. Now it comes before the noun, which is the another noun in the sentence, dishes. But that dishes belongs to that cat only, no? So that is why a possessive noun always comes before the noun that belongs to it. Understood? We add only an apostrophe to make a plural noun ending in S, possessives. I told you already. Children, suppose the plural words are there which are ending with S. In such words, only we add apostrophe sign, not another S. Boys, dogs, girls. Here, children, already these words are in a plural form and ending with S. So, no need to add another S for it. Only apostrophe sign is enough. Okay? We add an apostrophe S to make a singular noun possessive. Suppose, children, the noun is in the singular form only. So, in this case, we can add apostrophe sign also and after that S also. Cat, cats. Cat is a singular form. Only one cat. And we added apostrophe S to it, that is cats. Boy, boys. Tom, toms. We add an apostrophe S to a plural noun that does not end in S to make it possessive. See here. We add an apostrophe S to a plural noun that does not end in S to make it possessive. Children, the plural nouns which are ending with S, in this case only we add the apostrophe sign. But the plural nouns which does not end in S, in that case we add apostrophe sign also and S also. For example, I told you child, children. Children is already plural noun, but this word children does not end with S. So that is why we have to add apostrophe S to it.
Yes, have you understood the chapter? Very good.
See, here is the summary. In this chapter, we have learned that nouns have a possessive form for which we use an apostrophe. Noun and to form the possessive. Most singular noun, how we form the possessive for it? By adding apostrophe S. The plural noun that ends in S, only apostrophe sign. The plural noun that does not end in S, add apostrophe S. The proper noun that ends in S, add apostrophe S. But the some special names that end in S, in that case, we have to add only apostrophe sign. So the possessive form usually occurs before the another noun in the sentence. This is the short summary. See, my map is there. Here is the possessives. For singular nouns, add apostrophe S. For plural nouns that ends in S, add apostrophe S. Children, here it is the, I think, wrong misprint is there. See here, for a plural noun that ends in S, we have to add only apostrophe sign, not to add S, right? For plural noun that does not end in S, add apostrophe S. This one is the correct. For special names that end in S, means some proper nouns, we have to add apostrophe S. And for a proper noun that ends in S, add apostrophe S. Here, children, for special names, here also no need to add S, only the apostrophe sign is enough. Socrates, Jesus, in such words. So, I hope you have understood this lesson very well. But still, you have any doubt, any queries, please note down and you can feel free to ask me by the mail. Okay? So, this was for the day. Take care of yourself. Stay home. Stay safe. Take care of your family, friends. And be healthy. Stay fit. Thank you. Bye-bye.